and welcome back to Shingen.io. We are doing a control router dash important. Ulili says, I'm pleased to say we have been selected for another Sun Hoish. Ah, I said this so well the first time. Hoshone? I don't know. A simple data router for smart grids. Mr. Sun was never interested in civic infrastructure before, to my knowledge, but I really wonder what he's planning. I may ask around. My uncle's had dinner with him once or twice. Shang-Ji says, we can do it. Note, these experts' inputs are blocking, so we will need to connect all inputs so they can be read simultaneously. Fuck you, Zhang. In. What the fuck is this thing doing? Oh my god, I don't even want to think about this. Meter in and meter out are inputs and output that connect this node to a building's power meter. Lower in, lower out, inputs and output with a lower ID number. First value in the packet is the ID number of the destination and indicate how the packet should be handled. The local ID number of the node is stored in the secure identity chip to be read on the box Xbox input. Second value in a data packet is the length of the rest of the data packet. So what the fuck? Store the values over here. And we probably can. Which one was? I think A is writing. don't know. I like that. Because how is it going? It's going to try to look for all of this. Tell you what. I'll tell you what. It's not gonna send it all at once. So.
Get all this information, blah blah blah.
that work? Is that, I just don't know if that thing's, I mean, it's, there's 596, blah, 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 blah. Shit. Alright, let's... I just want to know if I can compare this without having to read the value. So we put all that out there, we get it to zero. Okay, now how does it compare? It is actually equal, so we should move 10 out. We do! Awesome! So we don't need to read this, it's just stored right there. That's beautiful. That is beautiful. So now all we need value stored here. Gonna work because we need to do the full value. So move this down, move this to accumulator. This for the moment. Let's cut that. Successfully storing the data pack. Now, what we need to do is find a way, essentially we need either this or this. Because I don't know that it can. I mean, it probably could. if we brought in the simple input. But I'm not sure. One of these two chips is going to be the answer. And I just need to determine who's doing the job of figuring out where it goes. Do I have this chip do that? I think this chip needs to do it. Greater move po? Is that what we're gonna do? Probably. Space. I'm just silently wondering if there's maybe a way I could avoid moving those, the first two values, because we've got them stored right here. But that's we need to do this off board, as much as I hate the idea of it. Yeah, I don't like the idea, but I think it's what we gotta do, unfortunately. So, let's see. Something like that. So you're sleeping. Once you wake up, if Po is equal to 100, if yes, sleep 1, if no, nope, sleep 1, god damn it, what's wrong with you, if, there, if yes, if no, sleep 1, wait, no, that's wrong, that's entirely wrong, if yes, how the heck are you doing the comparison, though? you gotta compare the two. How are you doing that? How are we? Alright, I think we're gonna have to use a bus as an in and an out, which is always fun. Move. Test how the accumulator compares to X2. Alright, so. You're gonna Slex until Zoe wakes you up. As soon as it does, move Exo via the accumulator. I think the steps I'm looking at are definitely not the steps I need. Sleeping until he wakes you up. He he's telling you where it needs to go. If it's put a sleep down here. So if it's greater than, because that's gonna stay greater than regardless. So if it's greater than, I don't know how to tell this chip how long the strings are without, you know, repeating that instruction. I'm just not sure. Idea, but it hinges on the truth that this packet will never send a zero. That's the way we've got this working right now. So, if it's higher than, move X1. Yeah, that's X1. Alright, move X1 to the accumulator. Test if the accumulator goes 0. probably do this a little differently, actually. Like this should do it. So we're gonna hit this test and we're gonna see what happens. Nothing happens. Nothing fucking happens. Because is it because these pins are connected? Are you just reading? Yeah, you're just taking that. Fuck. Fuck, fuck, fuck. Okay, so we could, let's cut this and try to do it with this thing. XO is still higher. X3 is still mid. Okay. So, I guess you're just going to sleep one. But, I forgot to copy the text from this one. So, what do? You select one. Move X1 into the accumulator. Test how the accumulator compares to XO. Thank you. That's probably not going to work. That didn't work. It waits, it gets that. Moves 10. But then it immediately moves 0 again. See, that's what I was afraid of. That's what I was afraid of. So, I'll tell you what. So it is writing it, it's just a meter, it's a time unit late, it would seem. I think it's working. It's just late by you. And I feel like the way I had it before would have worked, except this thing was sending the value straight out instead of into this. So then, let's cut that. Would be that these two connect to the same. Now. Alright, Slex, until X1 wakes you up. Once it does, move X1 to the accumulator, compare it at sleep. Because that is constantly sending information. Of course it is. That would be too fucking easy. Son of a gun. Another chip. What about it? At all. Thank you. know if I need that bit. Son of a bitch. Okay, you wake up. You take your zero. You take your 10, rather. You're gonna move X1 to the accumulator. So you're gonna take your 5, 9, 6. Okay. It's not a zero. So you should move that out. Move that 5, 9, 3 out. Jump to move. Take your next value. Still not a zero. Okay, jump it out. Ba, ba, ba. This is all good. There's your 17. Close. We're really close, ladies and gentlemen. 17. All right, move it out. Jump to move. Move the zero in. Is it zero? If it is zero, move. Zero to X3. That should do it. What? It worked perfectly for this one. Okay, so what goes wrong? 301, da da da. Okay, we rewrite all that thing. You're 301. How does it compare to ACC? It should be less than ACC, so it should move 1 to X2. Okay. You're going to take that 1. You're now going to we're not resetting this device. But now we are. Now we are, ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and fucking gentlemen! I believe we've done the goddamn thing. Woo! Alright, that is perfect. Let's do the talk through. That is just over an hour on this one. 4 fucking chips. I probably didn't need it, but we got it, and I'm goddamn happy yet again. So here we go. Sleep until something comes in. Something is coming in. Okay, so this chip's job. It will take the first value, store it in data. The second value, store it in the accumulator. Now, it will, this is waiting. So this one will now move the data down to here. So it gets stored on board. Then move the accumulator down there so it gets stored. Now, it will also send this data up to this chip. Boop, there you go. It's going to read that. And now it's going to test. Is the accumulator equal to zero? The accumulator has the second number, and the second number tells us how many more numbers are coming. So we just put that up there. If it's zero, we'll just reset this chip and move on. If it's not zero, we're gonna take the next value, send it down here, subtract 1 from the accumulator, and jump back and test again if it's 0. Okay, so that's all that chip is doing. And that is, I mean, that's really it. I don't exactly know why it's taking these two values here. I guess just so it can Well, it's putting this value here because it needs to know how long the string is, and it's putting this value here because it needs to send it to this chip again. So it needs to keep it on board so it can send it back out. Okay. So yeah, that's why we're doing it like that. Makes sense to me. Five nine. And then you send 599 up here. This thing will bring the 599. Okay, 599. Thanks. Compares how it compares to this secure number. This number, judging by information, says the local ID of the node is stored in the secure identity chip. So it compares it to that number. It happens to be the same number this time, so it's going to skip all these pluses and minuses and send a 10 to this chip. And this is just a little code I've given. If it's greater than, it's 100. If it's less than, it's 1. If it's even, it's 10. And that figure will tell this chip where to send the signal. But it sends that 10 out. That will wake up both of these chips. This chip down here will just start reading this value. So it's going to take this first one, see if it's a 0. If it is, it sends a 0 to here, goes back to sleep. If it's not, it's going to work on sending this up here. But right now, let's look at what this one's doing. It's going to move. It's waiting for that value. It's waiting for this chip. So this chip will, it's not a 0, so it's going to send the value it read out. 596. This one gets your 596, puts it in there. Is that a 0? If it is, go back to sleep. If it's not, test how the data compares to 10. If it's greater than 10, move it out high. If it's less than 10, move it out low. If it's even, if it's neither of those things, move it out here. And regardless of where you move it to, so we're going to move it out even, regardless of where you move it to, then jump back and wait for the next signal from this chip. So this chip is now sending out the 4. That one takes the 4. This chip jumps back up to get the next value from the reservoir. Is it a 0? Nope. Then send it on. Same thing's going on up here. Move it in. Is it a 0? Nope. Then find out where it goes and send it on. And that's all they do until they finally do get a 0. Here you go. It's 0. So move 0 out and go to sleep. Move this 0 in. Is it a 0? Yes, it is. Go to sleep. Boom. Everybody's asleep. Beautiful. I mean, the only thing really left to say is, where this thing resets. It looks like what I'm seeing now is a 0 doesn't clear it. It simply sends it. It sends the writer up to the next level, which seems to be just fine. So this one's 7. Are there any 8 strings? There are no 8 strings. If there were an 8 string, we might be in a situation, but This is more like it. Look at this. Production cost over twice as much as it should have cost. Power usage is way up there. Lines of code is way up there. That's more like it. This is just the tip of the iceberg. Mr. Sun is apparently pulling in a lot of resources and groups to create various subsystems for something. Nobody knows what it is other than it's going to be very big and potentially very lucrative for the firms involved. We are on a path to further our good relationship with this group and eventually become trusted partners. So let's continue to do our best work here. Alright, cool. Is that pocket eye change? Or is that... Oh, boy. I'm just very cursory looking through this. Much more detailed process. I don't like the sound of that. But, obviously, that's going to be next time. Thank you so much for watching this one. I will see you next time.